Welcome you all to this section. Today we are going to discuss some important topics in fluid mechanics and machinery. The code is CE8394. Today we are going to discuss certain aspects in the course outcome 5. So that is, we are seeing certain working principles. We are going to oversee certain working principles of turbines. Okay, so we'll have some introduction over the efficiency. The operations will be discussed in the forthcoming sections. Today, this section is being devoted for general understanding of the turbine operations. I shall go on to the turbine's fifth unit. So, we're going to have the classification of turbines, its efficiencies, the velocity triangles. We'll have the Pelton wheel, Francis turbine, Kaplan turbine, the working principles, work done by water, work is the work done by this water, draft tube, specific speed, unit quantities, and the performance curve, everything else. And also, we'll have some information, we'll be discussing some information regarding governing of turbines. Okay, now we'll see what is a turbine. A turbine is one which is used for converting this hydro power into mechanical energy. Hydraulic energy is being converted into mechanical energy. So normal, we are going to have certain general discussion only in this session. So what can be the parts of water turbine? It will have a wheel, or it can be a runner, and the vanes or blades, or we call it as buckets, you can see here. Okay, so these are the general parts of a water turbine. And also we can see the word turbine was actually, you can see the diagram show how it is operating. You have the turbine blades, a wicket gate. Okay, you have the turbine generator shaft is being connected to the generator, stator, and also rotor. So here actually This word turbine was being coined by the French engineer, okay, Claude Bourdin, and actually it was derived from the Latin word for whirling or vortex. In the sense, the liquid is being whirled out, isn't it? So that we have it as a, we call it as a turbine. So I was discussing about wicket gates, isn't it? So what is actually a wicket gates? The wicket gates are playing a key component in hydroelectric turbines. The main purpose of this wicket gates is that they control the flow of water from the input pipes, that is, we call it as penstock, to the turbine propellers or the runners. So they will be controlling the amount of water that is being flowing from the input pipes or penstock to the turbine propellers or the runners. Okay. Okay. Next one. So how we can have it as a classification of turbines? Okay, we'll have certain classification of turbines. What are they actually? So we can see that first one is according to the action of water. We have it as impulse turbine, that is Pelton wheel turbine, and reaction turbine is Kaplan turbine and Francis turbine. So according to the direction of flow is tangential flow turbine, radial flow turbine, the axial flow turbine, and mixed flow turbine. Okay, so whatever it is, we'll be discussing them in detail in the forthcoming sessions. Today we'll have some introduction over these types of turbines. According to this head, okay, so what is the head? The major head, we do have it as 1770 meter. We have it as high head turbines, or we call it as impulse turbines, that is Pelton wheel turbine. And medium head turbines, we do have it as from 60 meter to 250 meter. The model is Francis turbine. And low head turbines is, we do have the heads of below 60 meter is Kaplan turbine. And what is known as specific speed, actually the Pelton wheel will be turbine will be varying from 10 to 35 for single jet and up to 50 for double jet. And the Francis turbine will be varying from 60 to 400, and Kaplan turbine will be varying from 300 to 1000. So what is actually, you can see what is the history of turbines. It was actually a inward flow turbine was being developed by Jean Victor. Okay, which was with a lower drive, and the efficiency was up to only 70%. Okay, after that what happens, Benoit was discussing, was developing an outward flow turbine. Okay, it was called it as, actually this was an efficient machine when compared with the previous version, that is we had a efficiency of 80% when compared with this. And the water was sent to your runner with blades curved in one dimension. Okay, and the stationary outlet had also some curved guides. Okay, so this efficiency was higher when compared with the previous version, that is the, it was developed by the scientist Benoit Fourneyron. And actually, this is in spite of this French military engineer, is Jean Vector. He has invented a water wheel with a lower drive. You know very well. Okay, how you can see how he has achieved this? Very simply, he replaced the straight vanes with the bent ones. If you see here, normally we do have the straight vanes that are being replaced with the bent ones. That's all. Okay. And in 1844, we had Boydon was developed. He developed an outward flow turbine, which was having some improved efficiency when compared to the performance of Fournier turbine. And actually, its runner shape was similar to that of Francis turbine only. And again, Francis improved the inward flow reaction turbine to over 90%. The previous one only 70%. And there was sophisticated test was being conducted, and they developed for some engineering and standard methods for water turbine designs. And he named as Francis turbine from him. Okay, it was the first modern water turbine, and now also it has been widely used in the world today. So this Francis turbine is also called as radial flow turbine. Okay, the water will be water flows from outer circumference towards the center of the runner. That is, we call it as a radial flow turbine. Okay, and again, 1879, we can have it as Alan Pelton. He was experimenting with the night wheel, which developed a double bucket design, which exhausted the water to the side. So the some energy loss was being eliminated, and which exhausted some water back against the center of the wheel. Okay, in 1895, William Doble also improved on Pelton's half cylindrical bucket form with an elliptical bucket. Okay, now it was that included a cut in it to allow a jet a cleaner bucket entry. So this is actually the modern form of Pelton turbine, which is achieving efficiency up to 92%. Okay, it's one of the earlier versions of Pelton wheel turbine. Around 1890, the modern fluid bearing was invented. So now it is universally used to support heavy water turbine spindles. Okay, and 1913, the Victor Kaplan also, he created a Kaplan turbine, a propeller type machine. So this is about history of turbines. And Pelton wheel is one of the most efficient types of water turbines, and it was invented by Lester Alan Pelton, and it's actually an impulse machine, meaning that it uses the principle of Newton's second law to extract energy from a jet of fluid. Okay, the law, what is it? The law states that the acceleration of a particle is directly proportional to the resultant external force acting on the particle, and is inversely proportional to the mass of the particle. Okay, so this is an application of invented an impulse machine, which is an application of Newton's second law. Okay, so Pelton wheels are used in the storage power stations with downward gradients up to 1770 meters, and they can contain up to 6 nozzles. Okay, and Pelton wheels are the preferred turbines for hydro powers when they do have a high head, hydraulic head at low flow rates. You can see the, please, you can see the diagrams. Okay, this was the Pelton's original patent. It was obtained in 1880 October. This is, okay, and this is the Pelton wheel setup. Please, you can see that. This is the diagrams which will help you in the easy understanding. Okay, this is impulse of Pelton runners. So Kaplan turbine. So Kaplan turbine is actually it was developed around 1915 by Austrian engineer Victor Kaplan. Okay, that has the two or more blades, and the pitch was being adjustable. So it was like a marine propeller. It resembled a marine propeller, and the turbine can also have gates so that to control the angle of the fluid flow into the blades. Okay, you can see this is Victor Kaplan. You can see the diagram visuals representing the Kaplan turbine. And where we are going to use this Kaplan turbine is, we are going to use where there is low head and a large amount of distance, was opposite to the previous what we saw. Okay, so the adjustable runner blades can give you high efficiency. Okay, even in the range of partial load, and there is a little drop in efficiency due to variation, due to head variation or load variation. Please, you see the diagram. and thus adjustable blade propeller. Okay, Kaplan and turbines have adjustable blades coordinated with adjustable wicket gates. You can please see in the diagram. Okay, the Francis turbine, what happens actually, it was done by Francis. He improved the inlet flow reaction turbine to overall to conduct to obtain the 90% efficiency, isn't it? So the type of hydropower reaction turbine is that contains a runner that has the water passages fluid formed by, what happens, you can see this reaction turbine, it has a runner that has water passages fluid formed by curved vanes or blades. Okay, the runner blades typically 9 to 19 in number cannot be adjusted. Please, again I am insisting, the runner blades cannot be adjusted. As the water is passing through the runner and over the curved surfaces, it causes rotation of the runner. The rotation motion is being transmitted by a shaft to a generator. Okay, the Francis turbine has a wide range of applications and it can be used for height from 60 to 250 meter. So the largest Francis turbine will have an output of 750 megawatt. Okay, you can see the visual. This is James B. Francis. This is a Francis turbine. Okay, you please see the visuals. This is the draft tube. So what is meant by draft tube actually? The piping system for a reaction type hydraulic turbine that allows the turbine to be set safely above the tailwater, and it is also used for utilizing the full height of the side from the headrest to the tailrest. Okay, this is the purpose of the draft tube. Just please see the diagram. Okay, this is a Francis setup. This is a Francis turbine runner, nearly rated at nearly 1 million horsepower or 750 megawatt, being installed in the Grand Coulee Dam. Please see the diagram. Okay. Okay, and also you know very well, Francis turbine will be having short buckets when compared with your centrifugal pump impeller. The Francis turbine, you can see what distortions, okay, the Francis turbine at the end of its life showing cavitation, pitting, fatigue cracking and a catastrophic failure. Okay, and earlier repair jobs that use stainless steel weld rods are being visible. This is a diagram which shows how there is distortion due to the cavitation, pitting, fatigue cracking. Okay, and Francis turbine will have from 60 to 250 meters, can have a head from 60 to 250 meters, and the output can vary from a few kilowatts to 1000 megawatts, and the size can be from few hundred meters to about 10 meters. Okay, you see the diagram for mixed flow propeller runner. This is various runners. Thanks for your patient listening, and we'll be discussing about the various turbines in detail in the forthcoming classes. Thank you all once again.